have sport back in the city, in this wonderful stadium.
Yes, we've been welcomed and well looked after as we look at the last five meetings between these two sides. Australia winning the three in the middle, but it's been Ireland. These two coaches, James Topping and John Minetti, have set high standards in 2022, and in particular, love what Ireland have done as well. In particular, saying that they're going to actually build, and that's what they've done, hence the reason to become one of the core teams.
Yeah, they built a program, both on the men's and the women's side, and this is a huge part of their development as Irish national team players. The Olympics, a big part of that conversation, where they were this year.
Australia captain Nick Maloof brings his players out onto the field. And one thing's guaranteed is that these two countries are brilliant places to visit. They certainly know how to enjoy themselves, the Irish and the Australians. And here was their road to the bronze medal. Perfect first day with three wins, and then the win against Argentina, the close loss to Fiji by seven. Some suggesting that they got a little bit rough in that one as well, got some rough calls. And how about this, the Giant Killers beating Fiji in the opening match and then losing to France, and that epic match to New Zealand went right down to the wire.
Yeah, great comeback by the man in black, Mick Hogan, in the middle, the referee. But if you'd have tuned in this time last night and seen this Australian side completely dismantle England, you'd find it hard to believe they're not playing for gold right now. They were sensational. That man's been brilliant, O'Toole, all weekend.
Corto.
As says that man, Dietrich Roach.
Good. New Zealand referee Nick Hogan asks if we're right. Australian mascot is in his place, and we're about to get underway. Rising high is Tool. In fact, it was McNulty, I should say, in jersey number three for the Irish. First possession. On the chain and into the contact they go through to Lennox. Such a patient side, this Irish team. It's been a real feature of what they've done over the last 3 to 4 years, that as they come to these tournaments, their ability to hold on to possession, as Roach gets rid of a couple of would-be tacklers, sets up possession inside the Australian half. Quickly it's released into the midfield again, stepping and looking for the players as Mullins isolated, but they get the penalty.
Yeah, and that possession you talked about, it's all about getting bodies over the ball, securing it phase after phase. That's time the Australian, sorry Willie, but it's guilty of hands in the ruck there.
Couple of the Irish players enjoy playing against Australia. They've racked up a number of tries, in particular Terry Kennedy, 6 tries in 8 matches against Australia. So keep an eye out for him. Again, into the contact. It's been all Ireland in the opening 1.5 minutes. Finally, Australia gets some possession.
Yeah, they will have the ball, but we should say both Jordan Connor and Terry Kennedy started this match on the bench. So either there's some injuries we don't know about, or there's a tactic here in play.
Interesting to see if there is a tactic and they get brought on at the second half when bodies are a little bit tired. Of the Australians now through Maloof, the captain, draws in 3 defenders. That means there's got to be space somewhere in the Irish back line. Turner wants to get on with it, trying to get on the outside, skipping past in Australia. Exactly the reason why they're so dangerous. No possession in the opening stanza of this game. First touch of the ball, and Corey Tool's in.
Yeah, that try takes him, I believe, to the top of the table against the Irishman, Kennedy. And watch the swerve running here, the balance running. Nothing that Onusu could do about it. Tool got his first hat-trick in this tournament. He continues, and he's leading the DHL Impact player table, and you can see why.
Chase Australia chasing 3 medals of 2022, 2 silvers, 1 in Dubai and also 1 in Spain. They really have gone to a new level in Australia.
Yeah, they're dressed, aren't they?
it's a nice sight if you're an Australian fan.
Well, exactly. Roach, just 20 years old. The beautiful execution of the kickoff, giving his team a chance to get up there. And Awanusi keeps his eyes on the ball. More possession for Ireland. Been shown the sideline from Maloof. There's McNulty, but he's brought down. And Ireland again look to try and force the issue in the midfield. Isolated, this could be a turnover. Ma was there and gets the ball. Here come Australia again. Ma with the offload, in fact defend, and he's going to race away to score Australia's second. And Australia go bang bang.
Yeah, stealing that ball, turning into attack. Watch this. Just again, I talked about that support of the breakdown. It was too slow, so he poached it and then thought he'd back himself. What a shout out to Nick Hogan, our referee. Took a shot in the back. The Kiwi got up and still awarded the try. Good for him.
Beautiful from the man on debut, 24-year-old Ben Ma. Lovely tall athlete with great skills, and it's high fives all round. Conversion successful.
Dietrich Roach adding the 2 points there. He is the leading point scorer on the series, 186 points.
Well, in the build-up to this tournament, the Australians, like the New Zealanders, went to Fiji for 2 weeks, and boy, if you ever want to learn how to play the game of sevens, you go to the best place in the world to learn, and that's Fiji. Really is showing how they've developed this Australian side. But Ireland now with an opportunity. Again into the contact they go with Mullen. Bullet pass. Finds the target. They just can't seem to get through this Australian wall. Seven players up in the line. Now they drop a sweeper back with Turner now in the sweeping position. Awanui gives it out to Lennox. The late cut. This is better from Ireland. Awanusi, he loses it. And the advantage is quickly over. The hand up from Maloof. Says, give it to me and I'll bring it back all the way here where the players are. And throws the big 30-meter pass that's drifted forward. Referee in great position.
I was just going to say, you can disagree, but you can't argue with position. Nick Hogan exactly where he needs to be to make that call. This is the turnover. Little pop out, and then Awanusi loses it in contact.
Stephen.
Watch this pass. Look at the ref. Yeah. Fantastic.
Australia wins against Samoa, Spain and England yesterday, and then great battle against Argentina, but the match against Fiji had the stadium in a frenzy.
Time on.
Yeah, I mean, great to see Fiji back, but the Australians just got the best of them and then couldn't get through to that final.
Sit!
Mark Roach feeds it and now looks for an inside ball. Stepping, this is better from the Irish, now inside the Australian half for the first time and inside the red zone. Numbers out to the right, good shape here. Awanusi just needs to straighten up. He needed to straighten before he passed, otherwise it was easy defense for the Australians. And to clear it is McDonald. Long bottom come racing out of the line, and so taken to the line was McNulty. Lennox to the right they go. Awanusi four short. Ball is there. Lennox is there again. Now the gap opens up. The advantage here for the Irish. McNulty should score. He's big enough and strong enough, but he hasn't got it down.
Held up.
Look at that shot there. That's three fun. Aussies enveloped the ball once it got over the line. McNulty, who's played so well this weekend. His body's everywhere.
Penalty for offside first.
Yeah, there's McNulty. He just goes forward all the time. But watch, Hutchison had the presence of mind. They go quickly. And they're going to have a look upstairs, I think.
Let's
see what the question is.
Try yes or no, please.
Hugo Lennox is the man that's getting up. He's pretty confident walking back.
He's allowed to bounce there. And then he gets on the line is good enough. Let's see if he actually is all the way to the line when he bounces. Yeah, there it is. Great work from the crew here. Two long days, boys and girls. Thank you very much for these shots. Makes it easy for our referees as well.
referees, but of course with the protocols that there are, now they're using the TMO a lot more today. And he hasn't given the all clear just yet.
I think this angle shows it clearly. There's whitewash under the ball and contact with the body.
When you're on film, you can award the try.
Can award the try. Well called.
Fantastic for everyone in the stadium too, because they now we got a game on our hands. Hugo Lennox gets five, and they add two more in the dying minutes of this first half. They've got a try.
14-7. Just enough time for the restart. Says Nick Hogan. As the Australians look on through Mark.
Willie, watch this kickoff. It's as high as they go. It's just remarkable what he does with it, how much time he has for his team to chase it.
Hang time was great. The Australians through long bottom. Watch him work. He is so strong. He's held on to the ball, and this will give the Irish real hope. The quick tap from Roach. Numbers to the right. They just need to draw and pass, but why draw and pass when you can go on your own? Ireland are back.
Well, we've been talking about Gavin Mullen this weekend as an impact sub off the bench. Obviously, great pedigree. Family of a fine finishing father, knows how to get it done. But watch how his nose for the line allows him to ride that tackle, roll over, and get his club within a conversion of being tied. And there it is.
All tied up. Ireland play sevens rugby in the last 30 seconds of the first half. All tied up after seven.
Back to the bench.
He's walking to the walking to the sideline.
He's on the pitch.
He is on the pitch.
Wallaby's a bit concerned at the moment. They've just given up a two-try lead.
Second half starts. Battle in the air. Long bottom will bring it down, and they'll just slow it down, get it to your playmakers, try and find an edge where there's a mismatch. Quickly, Australia with possession, and McNulty said, can I help myself, sir? And the referee said, you can.
Well, a scything tackle from Billy Dardis there, and McNulty causing problems as he does all the time in the referee's ear, but they've won the penalty.
Such a hard-working forward, Harry McNulty, the 29-year-old. Just love the cut of his jib. The Australians not taking the kickoff, and it's created problems like this.
Yeah, look at that tackle. Textbook stuff. McNulty on his feet, competing. And again,
come off the line. Goal.
The arriving Henry Hutchison penalized for not supporting his weight.
Down.
McNulty, the target. First job done. Where do they go here? The short ball initially, and then the offload to Mullen.
Tackle!
He's tackled, and they've got a release. In goes Smith. Ball is still there, so Mullins comes into play half. Conroy still waiting for possession out on the right-hand side. Now, the Australians well aware of that, and that's why I thought gaps might be there, but the referee says holding on. Long bottom doesn't waste any time, just taps and gets on with it.
Australia's version of the super sub, long bottom on the field, the white boots. Can he find some space?
Tool gets it back to Maher. He's a big and strong. Athletic Ben Maher, they try and grab Longbottom. He's got that beautiful halfback pass of 30 meters. It's find some space, and his captain loops around Longbottom. Longbottom to the line. Dummies, fans, thought about the offload. And Hutchison, good body position on that occasion. Tool to Maher. Big long levers as Ben Maher pops the ball up to his teammate in Roach. Stepping was Gonzalez. Beautiful big hit coming in, but Australia still in possession. Long bottom back into the playmakers, into the midfield. This is where Roach is so dangerous and so strong. They needed something big, and he's come up trumps. Australia take the lead again.
Yeah, Dietrich Roach has had a big weekend, three in Singapore this week. There's the offload after the big tackle. Dietrich Roach on many people's list. Well, we'll be on your list. If you want to vote for the HSBC Dream Team here in Singapore, you've got to be a leading candidate. The offload game leading, scoring points, and now scoring tries in the bronze medal match.
Kick to take them out to the maximum seven. Converts his own try.
Well, isn't this great about the sevens? We're pretty much sure that isn't the last score. There's 3.5 minutes to go. This one's still in the balance.
Well, the Irish showed in 60 seconds they're able to draw level with two tries. Here he is, Morris Longbottom. So much potential for this young 27-year-old.
Right, you ready?
Terrific athletes.
Time on.
Saw a lot of them, a lot of their games that they played in Fiji over those 2 weeks. Bringing some of that confidence here to Singapore, Australia. That ball's just gone a little bit too far. Somehow it's been knocked on.
Yeah, McNulty didn't quite get it done there, but so much to play for. The series table continuing. Here they were in round five here, and there's Roach at the top of the points table.
Isn't that fantastic?
Let's go.
Great graphics that we've got to come up, and there you go. Nathungu. And he's also great with the assists. That's why he's in the Dream Team.
Six.
Has been named in the Dream Teams in the past. Longbottom, keep an eye out for him.
Backwards.
Lost the ball forward, and now Dardis says thank you very much. Nothing really on from a standing start. Roach with a nice tackle around. The boot laces on Kennedy. It's quickly cleared by Mullen. And to the midfield. Haven't really seen too much of Conroy.
It's gonna be trouble.
It's gone past.
I think he's lifted him above the level line, and it was a good tackle. He closed the space really well. But Willie, I think it's what he did after the fact. He lifted him, didn't take care of him, and he gets above the horizontal there and drives him into the ground.
Well, the player's well aware that safety is everything, and the referees doing what's right, and so Maloof will be off for the next 2 minutes. Great opportunity here for the Irish, the captain in the sin bin. Haven't mentioned his name in the second half. Jordan Conroy, is this his time?
Yeah. Great, yeah, open up, thank you.
We will see, this is straight from the training pitch. This is the work, 40 meters out. What are they gonna conjure up?
Throw the straight, which was the main thing. They'll take it to the line initially. Through Gavin Mullen, ball comes out, quick play, and now the kick for Conroy. Bounces up, reaches down. Well, they know what a threat he is. They've seen plenty of his back with the number seven on. Steps and stands, and now Kennedy needs a little bit of assistance. Great defense from the Australians. Take a bow, Henry Hutchison.
Leave it.
Kennedy and Hutchison having a few words. But credit Hutchison, he's stuck with it, the jackal roll. He's been penalized twice. Conroy, it's an unlucky bounce there. Tool just scrags him. Ireland just ran out of players. They had free offloads, but no one to give it to. You see Kenny looks up, one, two, no one to give it to. And Hutchison's right over the top, earns a crucial penalty.
Saw him when he came in as a young 18-year-old making his debut, Hutchison. The little baby-faced assassin he was called. But
12 side entry.
He didn't roll, and now an opportunity. Ireland with a full steam ahead. They pop the ball up, the dive gets a 10 from the Tongan judge. Did he get it down? Andrew Smith.
The question is, and we've had confirmation he can award the try. He's in the air, the ball goes down before anything touches outside. What a response from Ireland, and Andrew Smith will be happy. The Leinster Academy man also has a group of mates here who are all studying in Singapore. He got them all tickets, and they are having a blast to tie it up. It hits the post. They will have another restart, though. Will it?
There's enough time there. You say that he's got friends that are here. This is the all-important restart of the weekend. Maloof's asking if he's got time to get back on. Look at the faces of these athletes who have given everything over the last 2 days. The bronze medal up for grabs. Who wants it more?
Okay, hold on. 40 seconds left. How are we on the bin? No, he's okay.
He's given him the time. Longbottom asked the question, how long is there to go, sir? The restart, all important. Taken down by the Irish. They've got it through Mullen. Longbottom sticks his hands in and gets the penalty.
First one was fine.
Surely the rock is formed there. There's hands in there. Longbottom's won it for Australia.
How long have we got?
Clean take. Scooped up by Mullen. Two men over the ball. That ball is not available to be picked up in my book.
30 seconds. The first one he should have got. That's what the penalty's for.
So,
yeah, there is the interpretation. He's saying the first go at the ball, the first jackal.
Time is on now. Let's go.
It was a fair jackle. So,
you go now. Go now. You can't delay that. No, it's not. Go, go.
They're going to tap and hold on to possession. Australia, they'll run the clock down. 15 seconds on the clock. Ireland looking for possession. Australia just wanting to play keep ball. Hutchison might have the last say of the game. The countdown is there, 3-2, they've got it now. Cleared. And they kick it to touch, green and gold win bronze in Singapore.
Well, they played a lot of great rugby this weekend. They deserve some hardware. Jubilation all around, but that team has as well. The Irish denied yet again their first bronze medal in some years.
Final score, Australia 21, Ireland 19, and a thriller.